Hello, I'm Justin Smith, and I'd like to share a few helpful hints for using NX composites. I've been tasked with investigating the feasibility of producing this roof panel using composite materials. To do this, I need to use the composites application and define the layup surface. I can determine the direction to place the ply layers by selecting reverse direction here. Then I can define the composite region by selecting the layup surface. The rosette is used as a coordinate system for fiber directions, which will be used for the producibility simulation. Translational lets me select a point on the face for the origin, and I can rotate the coordinate system. Here, we will select the standard definition, and I can select a surface, origin point, and a zero direction. With the rosette defined, I can define the laminate by selecting the layup surface and rosette. Then I will go to the composite navigator and select ply. The laminate will be selected automatically, and I can select the region, then set the orientation of the ply layer. We can see there are currently no composite materials available, so I go to Choose Material. There are no existing libraries for composites within NX, so I'll have to create my own by selecting Create Material. I'll name this material Woven Composite, then define the material properties. I can choose the form, which will be woven for this material, and we'll keep the weave angle as it is. We will change the area density and the roll width since we will be using 1200 mm wide rolls. Uncured and cured thickness will remain the same for our material, and the shear limit will be set to 35 degrees. The shear limit is used to determine whether the material will stay on the surface during production. Once I have defined the properties, I click OK, select the material, and click OK. After I've verified everything is correct, I can select Apply to create the ply layer. Since the composite uses the same material, I can change the orientation and select Apply. I can repeat this until I have the layers that I need. Now I can run a producibility simulation by selecting Apply and a point on the surface. You can see that this arrow shows the origin direction of the weave. For this layer, the weave is at 0 degrees. The cell size can be automatically determined based on the object selected, but for our purpose, we'll set the cell size to 50 and run the simulation. Once this simulation is complete, you can examine the results and a flat pattern preview is also shown in this window. There are not any red regions, so this ply can be produced using the material. I'll repeat this process for each ply layer. You'll notice that the weave direction also follows the angle dictated by the rosette. We can see all of the layers in the simulations. If I just want to view a single layer, I can hide these other layers and take a closer look at layer 4. It looks like we won't get any separation with this part. In this demonstration, we created a layup using an existing sheet body. We then created a new composite material in NX and added apply layers to the model. Then we performed a producibility simulation to determine if the material could be used to create the part. Thank you.